Welcome back to another video of Latent Customs. We actually solved like the entire brake situation we have right here. So I actually told you guys there was a theory that you can use the exactly the same caliper and do the ventilator disc conversion on any Mark 1. And we successfully did that. The key is to buy brake pads that has a little bit less meat on, that is exactly the same shape as the normal brake pads. Get you the ventilated disc and buy your brake pads with little less meat on, like it has less brake meat on. I hope that makes sense all of you guys. Luckily a local shop here by us named Sondespace actually sells that brake pads, which helped us a lot in the long run. The brake pads we bought from Cityspace were actually the wrong one, and I know there are a few Mark 1s, like especially like the 2008 and above Mark 1s that have a different caliper, but in this situation we made it work with the old spec or the current caliper we have, which is like the 2007 and below models of the Mark 1s. We made that work and we converted Jody's caddy into a ventilated brake setup in the front suspension, which is like super amazing for us.
Nope.
Let's go!
Well, they're not very really happy, guys.
There you have it!
There you have it!
There you have it! And there you have it!
Now we can actually move forward to installing the CVs and the shafts. We still need to install one tie rod in, and then we're basically done with the front suspension. Then we're gonna actually start bleeding the entire brake system. I'll run you guys through that. As well, you start off with the furthest point from your brake booster cylinder and you move onwards to like, well, the nearest point of your braking system to the brake cylinder. I'm gonna break you guys through all that real quick. I forgot to mention that we actually bought the correct brake pads at Sondespace today, and we actually got it fitted as well. It's very dark to see that, but everything is on. We actually just sprayed the brake caliper silver just like for, well, before look, we know this won't last like longer than 2 weeks, but it's just for the thought of it. We still need to do a wheel bearing on the driver side, but we will do that in the near future because that wheel bearing install, well, it's just for testing purposes. We want to try to spend minimal money to get the caddy running, but still do a very, very decent job. So Jody doesn't actually want to spend unnecessary money where, well, you don't need to spend money at the current moment to get the buggy up and running. So now we're actually just gonna start by connecting this with the driver side tie rod in. We're gonna bleed the braking system and install the CVs and, well, the shafts. Very basic. It's just the adding keys in the center by the gearbox you need to tighten. Be careful whenever doing this. You have like half moons that you need to connect to each two adding keys you connect. That literally almost fell. Almost fell. It's like half moon stuff, I'm sure many Mark 1 owners know. You need to have that on your inner CV setup. Whenever you're tightening up, in this kind of situation we won't be using it because we can't find Jody's inner CV setup half moon stuff. And we're gonna just tighten it up just like this, just for the current moment. We will eventually buy some, but we just wanna get the caddy up and running and see how it actually performs, because we would like to drive around the caddy Saturday. Today is Wednesday?
Yeah.
Yeah, today's Wednesday. We want to drive the caddy Saturday, so hopefully we can get everything sorted. Probably. Fingers crossed. We still need to do the loom in the rear, but we will get to that real soon. You guys are not chilling, remember? We need to work.
I guess we
work
after.
Fine. I'm gonna work now. Yay!
Oh yeah.
That is Tyron's office, guys. Just excuse Tyron, that is his office.
Operational.
He's operational in the office. I'm gonna get you guys on the stand. We're gonna start by installing the CVs and the shafts. Very basic. 6 Allen keys on each side. Then you have, that's for the inner CVs. Then for the outer CV, you just have a nut in the center of your hub. Make sure you tighten that up very, very tight whenever the car is on the ground. You won't be able to tighten it very, very tight when it's in the air, or when your braking system is not fully functional, like in this current situation. So lower the car, and if you're doing this entire setup all together, make sure you first bleed your braking system and then move over to tightening the center nut for your CVs on the ground. So let me get you guys on the stand. Currently, Jody actually finished the CVs and the shafts. We just need to tighten the center nut of the hub on both sides, then we'll be sorted. We still need to tighten this turret in as well as the turret in on that side, and then we are kind of done with the front suspension. We can get the wheels on, get the car lowered, or the carry lowered to the ground. Unfortunately, we don't have any brake fluid, so I don't think we'll be able to bleed the brake system today. But like I mentioned in my previous video, we still have like a lot of like work to do with the rear suspension, so hopefully we can inspect that in one of our upcoming videos to see what's actually going, or what's actually going on in the rear suspension of the caddy. And we still need to lower the rear suspension of the caddy as well, so hopefully we can do that in an upcoming video as well.
Zijn je gepozen car? Die werkt zo
wel. I got him. I got him with his small talk. I got him. We finally got everything sorted on the caddy. So now, me and Jody, we're gonna fit the front wheels back on the caddy. And we're gonna lower the caddy to the ground. The only thing we still need to fit is the clutch cable, but I don't think we'll get to that tonight. We actually found a brake fluid bottle, which was actually full here by us, and we bleed the front brakes alone. This is actually the very like a completely wrong method to follow. You need to bleed the entire system whenever like messing with your braking cylinder or your master cylinders, you need to bleed your entire braking system, and that's exactly what we did not do. So like I mentioned earlier in this video, you need to start off with the furthest point, which will be your driver side rear wheel. Move on to your passenger side rear wheel, move on to your driver side front wheel, and then your front passenger side wheel. That's like that's a sequence you'll have to follow whenever bleeding your braking system. We just did the front suspension and we just did the driver side first, then the passenger side, just to make sure we at least have front brakes. So well, it's just for now, I guess we still need to do like redo everything I just explained, but it was just to make sure everything's perfectly fine in the bucket kind of have like has brakes, because at the moment there's absolutely no brakes on this cab. We made some good progress tonight, progress I did not think we would make, but we finally made some progress. But we finally made some good progress. We're gonna get the wheels on, get the bucket lower to the ground, and then hopefully soon we can actually see this bucket driving in and out of the yard.
Hey!
What do you guys make out?
We're buddy selling stuff here.
We're doing business.
We're doing business.
Persnors.
Oh, fast air.
I like the way that you move.
And there we have it! While getting the caddy on the ground, we actually got the class cable connected as well, so the caddy should drive like it should move to the front and to the back and brake as well. But unfortunately we can't do that because the caddy is super loud. We do need exhaust like bolts to clamp the branch to the exhaust. We're gonna find a way to do that tomorrow, because we can actually soften the caddy somehow, because this caddy is extremely loud, and I think we would like to take this caddy around the block this weekend. So I think the best solution would be to actually connect the middle section of the exhaust and just tow the caddy to the exhaust place to get the rest of the exhaust just welded on, so that we can at least have a full exhaust on the caddy, and well, it not being extremely loud. But that will be all for today. I hope you guys appreciated this video. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe and comment down below. I think it was a night well worth it. We made so much progress. We solved the brake issue, we got the CVs and the shafts on, we got the tie rod ends on and we got the clutch cable connected as well. So we got Tyrant's head on
and we bled the system also.
Yeah, we basically bled the brake system as well, but it was like a half, well, not very cool kind of brake,
a semi bleed.
It was a semi bleed because we didn't bleed it properly, but we will do so in the future before you guys start like tapping that keyboard and start commenting down below. So yeah, that will be it for today. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.